Today I want to talk to you guys about a few things that is coming with Season 5, which is also called Season of the Forge, and we're going to start right now. What's up guys, Reckless here, and welcome to Guardian Watcher. So, today, I wanted to talk to you guys about a few things that will be coming to Season 5, aka Season of the Forge, in Destiny 2. But before we get into the video, if you haven't already entered into the Destiny 2 Forsaken giveaway for the month of December, and remember, there will be four winners, yes, four winners, then click on the link in the description box below for your chance to win. Also, since this video is airing today, which is Turkey Day, I just wanted to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving. That includes your family, friends, heck, even people that you don't even like. But I definitely wanted to give a huge happy Thanksgiving shout out to all of my kids. I love all of you and I miss you guys very much. Now, all of the sources for this video will be in the description box below. So, Season 5 marks the Season of the Forge. It will begin next week, November 27, 2018, and most likely it will happen at reset time. You can expect that since this is the Season of the Forge, that there will be a lot of new weapons and armor because, well, that's what a forge makes. But all jokes aside, this is the first DLC in Destiny 2 since Forsaken has launched, and it is not the last one either. The Season of the Forge is also the very first DLC that is included inside the Destiny 2 Forsaken Annual Pass. There will be two more DLC releases after the Season of the Forge that will bring us all the way to the summer of 2019. One of them is called the Season of the Drifter, and the third season's name is currently unknown. So, with the Season of the Forge, we will be getting a few changes to the game. One of those changes is how Gambit will work. Starting with the bounties. Infamy rank points for all bounties have been doubled. Dailies, challenges, and weeklies will now take less time and it will be easier to complete. And finally, we will be getting a new bounty added to the daily rotation that requires Primeval Envoy kills. Infamy subdivision ranks, which is the ranks with the Roman numerals, will now award Gambit legendary weapons or armor. Bungie will be changing the Primeval catch-up mechanic as well. Now, the team that summons the Primeval second will only get one catch-up stack of Primeval Slayer. Now, truthfully, I see what Bungie is doing, but this will definitely make it a lot harder for the second team to catch up. And I actually feel that Bungie should have at least made the catch-up stack, like, maybe two instead of just one. And they also fixed another bug with the Ascendant Primeval after it was killed. Apparently, there was a glitch where the other team would get the credit if your team was the one that actually killed the Ascendant Primeval. As I said, it's been fixed now. Also, on November 27th, all Season 4 ranks will reset. This includes Nightfall, Valor, Glory, and Infamy ranks. Any incomplete triumphs or quest steps that require a specific objective in a single season will also be reset, and any incomplete triumphs with Season 4 in the title will be removed. However, quest for Pinnacle Crucible weapons will not be removed. Again, it will not be removed. So if you didn't get to finish your Luna's Howl or Regic's Broadsword, then go get it because it will stay in the inventory. And any progress that requires a certain rank will be lost due to the reset, but you will not lose the progress on that part of the quest. I hope that makes sense. Now, it is not said that Lord Shaxx will still have those quests available for you to pick up in Season 5, or the Season of the Forge. So, just to cover your six, go ahead and grab them now. Also, if you are hoarding any of those Prismatic Facets or Steadfast Engrams, then you will need to redeem them before November 27th because they will be expired and you won't be able to use them. So, spread the word about that to everyone you know. Another important fact is that if you have completed Gambit bounties going into Season of the Forge, then you must, I'll say it again, you must complete a Gambit match and then turn in those bounties. You will not get credit for it if you do not do a match in Season of the Forge first, and you will lose that bounty. Now, a few moments ago, I did mention Pinnacle Crucible weapons. In Season of the Forge, Bungie is expanding on that And they will not only give us Pinnacle Crucible weapons, but also Pinnacle Vanguard and Gambit weapons as well. The Pinnacle Vanguard weapon is called Loaded Question. It's a high-impact arc fusion rifle. Its intrinsic perk is called Reservoir Burst, which, when the battery is full, your next burst deals additional damage and causes the enemy to explode on death. That just sounds pretty badass. This weapon has three main quests, and the second quest step has sub-quests, and technically, the first and the last quests don't really count. The first quest step is for you to actually pick up the quest from Zavala, and the second quest step is to get 500 fusion rifle kills, 1,000 arc kills, both in any strike or nightfall, and 40 strike or nightfall completions. After all that is done, then head back to Zavala to receive your fully masterwork Loaded Question, and that is quest step 3. However, if you want to double dip while doing this quest, you can actually use either the main ingredient, the Techian Force, or the Queen Breaker to do this quest since they are all arc fusion rifles. Next, let's talk about the Gambit Pinnacle weapon. It's called Breakneck, and it's a precision auto rifle for the kinetic slot. And the intrinsic perk on this is called Onslaught, which this weapon's rate of fire increases as you stack Rampage. So in a sense, it's actually similar to how Outlaw and Desperado work together for the Claymore. This weapon also has three quest steps, and the second step having sub-steps. The first and last quest steps are to pick up the weapon from the Drifter, and then pick up the fully masterwork of the Breakneck when you are finished. The more important is the second quest step. We need to get 500 auto rifle kills, 100 auto rifle multi-kills, defeat 150 challenging enemies, and all of that I'm assuming is in Gambit, and then we also need to complete 40 Gambit matches. So good part about that is you don't have to win them, you just need to complete them. So that definitely could help. The Crucible Pinnacle weapon also has three steps, but Bungie didn't specify if we have to get the quest from Lord Shax or if the quest begins with step 1, and I'll explain that in a second. So, the Crucible Pinnacle weapon is called the Mountaintop. It's a kinetic lightweight grenade launcher with the intrinsic perk called Micro Missile, which this weapon fires in a straight line and has a massively increased projectile speed. Additionally, the projectile instantly detonates on the environment instead of bouncing like traditional grenade launchers, unless you have sticky grenades selected. So, that at least tells you there will be sticky grenades on this weapon. So step 1 of the quest requires you to reach Brave in the Glory Ring. Now this is exactly why I said I'm not sure if Lord Shax gives us the quest, or if we reach Brave in the Glory Ring, the game will automatically give it to us. So that's kind of up in the air. Quest 2 is actually more interesting because it does not require you to complete the subquest, only in comp. So we need to get Grenade Launcher Final Blows and earn a total of 750 points. Non-competitive playlists gives us 3 points a kill, and in comp, we get 10 points a kill. Then, after that is completed, we will need to rapidly defeat groups of 2 or more enemies and earn a total of 200 points. Non-comp double plays gives us 2 points a kill, and each subsequent kill after the double is 1 point. In comp, double plays are 5 points, and each subsequent kill after is 2 points. Next, we need to earn calculated trajectory medals and earn a total of 100 points. Non-comp is 1 point each medal, and comp is 4 points. And last but not least, step 3 is everyone's favorite step, and that is to reach the Fable rank in Glory. But as of right now, it doesn't look like there's another weapon that you get when you reach Legend though. But I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see when the Season of the Forge is actually released to find out if that's true. So there are a lot of things coming with Season of the Forge, like new vendors, the Black Armory, and like so much more that actually can't be put in this video, but I will be getting into it in other videos. As you guys can see, this is only a little bit of the amount of what we actually know for Season of the Forge, and November 27th is only getting closer and closer by the day, and I am crazy excited about this release for Season 5. So, what do you guys think about the changes for the upcoming season of the Season of the Forge? Let me know in the comment section down below, and we'll definitely talk about it. Once again, happy Thanksgiving to everybody and your families, and please, be safe out there tonight. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to watch these videos as well. You never know. You just might like them. And if you do, leave a like, share them, and then come back for more, because you know you want to. Thank you guys for watching, and remember, less guns doesn't mean less crime. And I will see you guys next time.